this, I will continue anapana session. But before we are trying to matter, I want to suggest you, some meditators, they want to continue more than 1 hour, etc. So because of this reason, while you are going, getting up, when you are opening the door, please train slowly, gently. It is better. Because some meditators, they stay together, 2 or 3 together. So because of this reason, their room is also not comfortable for meditation. They want to meditate here for a long time, but some people, when the bell rings, they get up. Other than they open the door, not gently, so it disturbs their concentration. Because of this reason, every time please be careful to open and or to close the door gently. Another reason is, after lunch, usually many meditators want to rest for a few minutes, for a short nap. At the day, showering is not good. So you should also fix showering time. After lunch, you should not do showering, it is better. Because some they want to take nap, a short nap. But some are showering, then they cannot sleep well. So because of this, after lunch, it is better not to shower. Okay. Then, everywhere, if you want to speak, please try and change everything. But low voice. Okay. Then, today, we will continue anapana session. Anapana gamathana also gave a deep hardship. Why? I want to explain in brief. Now you have been already practiced anapana, four stages in samatha meditation, long breath, short breath, the whole breath body in, tranquilizing the whole breath body formations. This is up to fourth jhana stage. After fourth jhana, then what you must do? You must discern ultimate mentality, ultimate materiality. This is mental body and physical body. Internally and externally both. Then you must discern dependent origination, their causes. If when you are discerning dependent origination, if you can do, then it is better 4 or 5 lives, up to 4 or 5 past lives. If you can discern dependent origination, it is better. But for future, you must try up to the end of your future. Because when you are practicing vipassana in Uddiyabhaya Jnana stage, rising in dissolution, inside knowledge stage, you must discern not only rising stage, causal rising, but also causal cessation, complete cessation. So because of this reason, you must try when you are descending dependent origination in the future existences, then after the end of future, you must try. After that, what should you do? This is another way. Usually, lakana rasa pichu patana patatana vasena namarupa parigaho deti visodhi nama. For purification of your right view, you should try to discern each mentality and materiality by way of characteristic, function, manifestation, and possible cause. Some characteristics are connected with dependent origination. Because of this reason, we teach this system later. For example, I'm transparent. What is I'm transparent? Rubhavi gadaraha buddha pasada lakana. The transfer of 4 elements, which is impingeable by kala. This is no much problem, you can easily understand. But there is also another characteristic. Dhatu gamma dhani dhana gamma smoutana buddha basada lakna vachaku. Dhatu gamma dhani dhana. In previous life, when you are accumulating whole swantamas, you have the intention to see visible objects. With such intention, you had accumulated wholesome karmas. So, based on this craving for sensual pleasure, you accumulate that wholesome karma. Because of this wholesome karma, four elements arise here. Transferring of these four elements is called Bhakti-sadha, untransferring element. In this case, this characteristic is connected with previous past cause. After you had been designed by the origination, other than you will understand what is your wholesome karma, what is your craving, which based on this craving, how do you accumulate this, how did you accumulate this wholesome karma? And then only you will understand. So because of this reason, usually we teach of the dependent origination to design each mental pattern as well as physical is materiality by way of characteristic, expansion, manifestation, and proximate cause. After you had been designed this, then it is ready to go to Vipassana. So if you want to go to Vipassana, how you should practice? The present ultimate materiality is very easy. You had been designed many times internally and externally ultimate materiality. So as a group is better. If you cannot contemplate then as a group, then you should contemplate here 54 rupas. Here 54, 54, then separately you can do. As long as they arise, they pass away. So they are nature and permanent. You should contemplate them as nature. At the time, you should not contemplate them as a small particle. Small particles are not the object of Vipassana. You must analyze these small particles. In each small particle, there are at least 8 types of materiality. These ultimate materiality are the object of Vipassana. So you must emphasize only ultimate materiality. 54, 54, and then as a general, the whole body also you should try to discern all ultimate materiality, and then you must contemplate them as nature, dukkha, ananda. As long as they arise, they pass away, so they are nature. But their arising and passing is very quick. You cannot follow nature very quickly. So nature is only slowly. Rising and passing must be very quick. So for example, 100 times rising and passing away, you can contemplate nature once, it is okay, no problem. So by seeing this rising and passing away very, very quickly, you must contemplate the nature. Not only internally, but also externally. When you are doing externally, from near to far away, slowly you must extend towards the same area. Up to infinite universe, sorry. Everywhere, wherever you pay attention, everywhere all materiality become nature. So all are same. Same means at the time, if you discern four elements in your goal, you can see only just a group of small particles. If you analyze these small particles, you can see 8 types of materiality. Element, water element, fire element, wind element, color, odor, flavor, nutritive essence. They, as well as they rise, they pass away very, very quickly. When they become gold, like solid, because in each kalapa there is fire element, that fire element can produce another new generation. In that generation, there is also fire element, that fire element also can produce another generation. So successfully for a long time, they can produce in this way. As long as they are producing in this way, then gold is still gold for physical eye. But for Western eye, there is no gold. As soon as they rise, they pass away. In the same way, if you pay attention, you are diamond. Ruby. There is no ruby, there is no diamond. If you discern four elements in that ruby or diamond, then you can see only just a small particle. If you analyze in each particle, there are 8 types of materiality. These are, as soon as they arise, they pass away very, very quickly. So they are also nature. In animate or animate, everything is same, all are same. So this is called Samana Lakana. All are equal, same characteristic. Other than all are nature, all are particles. There's no diamond, there's no ruby, there's no gold, there's no silver, there's no US dollar. Yes, if you pay attention point in that US dollar, you can see only just small bodyguards. So all are ego, all are same. So this is because of this reason they are called Samana Lakana, equal characteristic. All have same characteristic. So if you gain this nature thoroughly, if you satisfy, then you can change dukkha. Why dukkha? The dukkha, the meaning of dukkha is very wide. They translate suffering. This translation is many educated persons, they don't want to translate like that. Because dukkha means always they are oppressed by rising and passing away. Because of this reason, Buddha gave this name dukkha. Everything and all over the world is dukkha. Why? They are always rising and passing away. They are always oppressed by rising and passing away. For example, maybe one lady have maybe take part, one children. As soon as take part, that children pass away. Again, another children. Then pass away, then pass away. So they are very dukkha, suffering. As soon as they rise, they pass away. So because of this, like such meaning only. Many people, they think this is pessimistic. Not pessimistic, this is true nature. Because as soon as they rise, they very, very quickly passing away, or dissolution. If they are dissolution, can we say this is sukha? Happiness. You cannot say, because they are not permanent. They are impermanent. So because of this reason, they are gift by name dukkha. So you must contemplate them in the same way. As long as they are always oppressed by rising and passing away, so they are dukkha. Then if you satisfy, then you can be addition another non-self. Why? If you contemplate this ultimate materiality, you cannot see any substance which is stable for a long time, per minute. So they are non-self. You cannot control them, not to pass away. Not to pass away. So they are another. According to your own desire, they will never come. Maybe may this rupa, this materiality not pass away, not to reach dissolution stage. Although you may have such intention, it is not okay like that. But as soon as it rests, it passes away. There is no permanent entity in them. So because of this reason, they are another non-self. After descending ultimate materiality internally and externally as anicca or dukkha or another, then in the same way you should try ultimate mentality also. Even your jhana dhammas, you may say, I can maintain my concentration 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours, but really, if you pay attention to these jhana dhammas, they are impermanent. As soon as they arise, they pass away. Then how you can say, I can maintain? Because this jhana consciousness is not same like sensual consciousness. Sensual consciousness means for your easy understanding, eye consciousness, ear consciousness, nose consciousness, tongue consciousness, body consciousness, such consciousness. They are, as soon as they rise, they pass away. If they are permanent, then always you must be seeing one thing, always the whole life, if they are permanent. So they are not permanent. Because of this reason, you can clearly see impermanent nature, but jhana dhammas are not like that. They can rise successfully for many hours, 1 hour, 2 hours, without interruption. So because of this reason, we can see she can maintain or he can maintain his concentration for 1 hour, 2 hours, etc. But although he can maintain this concentration, but actually while he is discerning this jhana dhammas, as soon as they arise, they pass away successfully for a long time. So you must contemplate them as nature. Because they are, as soon as they arise, they pass away, so they are nature. They are always oppressed by rising and passing away, so they are also dukkha. There is no permanent entity, permanent substance, so they are another, no self. Why we are contemplating like that. To arise in our mind, this chantment inside knowledge, this is very important. If you to remove craving or to remove attachment, this chantment inside knowledge is very important. Living down Virichati, in this way Buddha talks in many suttas. If you have this enchantment, then you will have viraga. Viraga means you have no attachment to these objects. Because as soon as they arise, they pass away very, very quickly. How you get attached? How you can have attachment to these objects? So because of this reason, Buddha gave to contemplate them as nicca, dukkha, anatta. Internally, externally. But there are many different ways you can do ultimate mentality, ultimate materiality as nature, dukkha, anatta. But some meditators, there are many difficulties. When they are contemplating ultimate materiality, they cannot grasp all materiality as a whole. So because of this reason, sometimes Buddha taught separately. If it is so, you must do separately. Eye transparent element, anicca. Ear transparent element, anicca. Nose transparent element, anicca. Tongue transparent element, anicca. Body transparent element, anicca. Heart base, anicca, etc. In this way, one by one, they must do. This way of practice also, 12 arana method or 80 element method. So in this way also Buddha taught. Because when they are discerning ultimate materiality, it is not clear in their mind as a whole. One by one, if they practice, it is very clear. So for those Buddha also taught 12 arana method also. Why? This depends on their parami. In previous life, when they are practicing vipassana, they emphasize only mentality, not materiality. Because they don't want to practice materiality evidently. They want to emphasize only mentality. So because of this reason, in this life, when they are practicing vipassana, when they are contemplating ultimate materiality, all are not clear in their mind together. So if it is so, they must do separately, one by one. Do by do, separately. This is one way. But other meditators, while they are contemplating ultimate meditation, it is very clear in their mind, very evident. But while they are contemplating ultimate mentality, they cannot grasp together. Because they are very quick, they are very subtle. So because of this, they cannot penetrate all together. For those Buddha also taught, four aggregate, four mental aggregate, feeling, perception, volitional formations, and consciousness separately. The amount, for example, Pachyana Dhamma 34. Among 34, you should emphasize only just feeling, maybe blissful feeling. Feeling, nature, okay. Then perception, nature, okay. Then the remaining mental factors, headed by volition, they are nature. Then consciousness, nature. So in this way, five aggregate method. So rupa is one aggregate, materiality is one aggregate, feeling one aggregate, perception one aggregate, mental formation is one aggregate, then consciousness is one aggregate. This five aggregate method is also okay. Maybe you may reach, and then so you have been reached, and then so another Dakana Sutta, second Samma. In that Sutta, Buddha gave instruction for five group bhikkhus, pinchavati bhikkhus, for higher ultimate prasadabana stage to arhat stage, to contemplate five gating metta. Yangenshi rupa, dita nagata, bichobana, ijadama, bhidama, olaridama, sukumama, inama, banidama, yandure, sandibewa, sabha rupa, nita, mama, niso, amasami, namiso, adadi, iwa, midanyata, buddha, sama, binyata, tabra. Whether past or present, future, internal, external, gross or subtle, inferior or superior, far or near, all 11 types of rupas, you must contemplate them as nicca, dukkha, anatta. In the same way, 11 types of feeling, 11 types of perception, 11 types of policing and formations, learning depths of consciousness, also Buddha is being in the same way. So this is five aggregate matter. When Buddha is pondering this Anatta Lakkhana Sutta, listeners, especially five group bhikkhus, they can follow the instruction. When listening to Dhammadho, they can contemplate 11 types of five aggregates as Nicca, Dukkha, Anatta. Because of this reason, at the end of this discourse, they all begin Arahat. This is present cause only. Past cause is this way of practice, they have been practiced in the end of Budhumudra Buddha. So, beginning from Budhumudra Buddha's time, they already practiced these five aggregate matters as Nicca, Dukkha, Anatta many times. So, because of this reason, when Buddha is expounding five aggregate matters, Vipassana, they can easily follow, they can easily contemplate them. This is one reason. Another reason is when Buddha is expounding Dhamma Chakka Bodhana Sutta, the first sermon, in that sutta, Buddha taught Four Noble Truths. What is first Noble Truth? Dukkha Sitya. What is Dukkha Sitya? Dukkha Sitya, Sankhijina Pinchu Badane Khanda Dukkha. In brief, five clinging agrees are Dukkha Sitya. So in that sutta, Buddha, in brief way, Buddha explained five clinging aggregates. What are five clinging aggregates? Whether they are past or present or future, internal or external, gross or subtle, inferior or superior, far or near. All 11 types of five aggregates are called five clinging aggregates. At that time also, they already practice this way to attain sotapanna state. So because of this reason, when their insight became mature, Buddha also taught this five aggregate matter again. So in this way also you can contemplate. In the same way, 11 types of, 12 types of ayarana matter, 80 element types of dhatu matter, this also you can do in the same way. So if you had been this ultimate mentality, materiality, internally and externally as Nicca, Dukkha, Anatta, then you must go back up to past life. How many past life? For example, you had been this ultimate mentality, materiality up to fifth past life. So from fifth past life to present to future, up to the end of your future, you must contemplate then rupa, Anicca. Then nama, Anicca. Or another way is rupa, Anicca. Virana, feeling, virana is Anicca. Then sanya, perception is Anicca. Then sankhara, formations is Anicca. Then consciousness, vijnana is Anicca. Nama, rupa, matta, or five aggregate matta, you should try in the same way, Anicca. And then dukkha, and then anatta. In the same way, you must do. When you are doing in this way, when you are inside become sharp, at the time, you can do 40 dots. Maybe this you can try to see and in the Visuddhimagga, the path of purification. Under Anicca Lakkhana, there are 10 characteristics. Under Dukkha Lakkhana, there are 25 characteristics. Under Anatta Lakkhana, there are 5 characteristics. This 40 way of contemplating also you must try in the same way. Why? To rise in your mind this chantment, whether past or present or future, all are impermanent, all are Anicca, all are Dukkha. If you understand in this way, Gliyara and Gliyara, then slowly this chantment will arise. You will not expect any future existence. Craving for future existence will be disappear slowly. This is important. If you have any attachment for future existence, then you must continue future existence. You must be reborn again in future. But if you have no attachment for future existence, then this life will be your last life. You can take pranibbana in this very life. So for this disenchantment, we must contemplate future as well as past. Sometimes present is not good. Oh, in past, we are very luxurious, we are very rich. In this way, you may go back you are attachment to past life. So because of this reason, past also nature, present also nature, future also nature, all are impermanent. We must try to see this impermanent nature. After that, there may be another way of studying Rupa Sadaka, the material subject, Arupa Sadaka, immaterial subject. This is also very good. Very good means our bodhisattva under the body tree, maybe especially last watch, when he is contemplating vipassana, he practices this Rupa Sadaka, material subject, and Arupa Sadaka, immaterial subject. This is very thoroughly, what called, thoroughly in detail examined ultimate mentality, immateriality as nature to another. So, within one day, minutely, within 100 years, every day you must contemplate it. So, very detailed. But it will take long time. So, after that, then you can go very, very quickly, if you can see rising and passing away in every mind moment. Then you can go to, you can reach at the Uddiyavijnana stage. Well, if you reach Uddiyavijnana stage, rising and falling, jnana, inside knowledge, up to that stage, if you can clearly see moment by moment rising and passing away, then you can do at the causal rising and momentary rising. Causal passing away and momentary passing away both. Yesterday we had been discussed, dependent origination. You should try to see the first five causes. Because of the rising of avijja, ignorance, prisandhi kamaja rupa arise. Because of the rising of craving, prisandhi kamaja rupa arise. Because of the rising of clinging, prisandhi kamaja rupa arise. Because of the rising of volitional formations, prisandhi kamaja rupa arise. Because of the rising of karma, karmic force, then volitional formations, prisandhi kamaja rupa arise. So because of this, this arise, you must try. Then you should try to see prisandhi kamaja rupa's rising stage, upada, rising stage only. This is causal arising. Because of this, this arise, this is causal arising. You try to see only rising state, this is momentary rising. So both causal rising and momentary rising, you must try. If you can do like that, then every five aggregate you must try according to six toes, and each toe there is in every mind moment you must do in the same way. When you have been discerned at dependent origination, other than this, what that also you must try. After that, not only momentary rising, causal rising, and momentary rising, then you must also try causal cessation and momentary cessation. You already designed these five causes, five causes. Then similar five causes will cease in the future. In which future? When you enter rahatship, at the time, this five similar, not this avijja. Because this avijja also nature. As soon as they rise, they pass away in past life. So they cannot follow up to future. But the post, coming post only future, follow up to future. But here, these five causes you should try to see. And the similar five causes, when you enter rahatship, then all ignorance, all craving, all clinging, all volitional formations, all coming force will cease completely without remainder. So you should try to see this complete cessation state. And then if you see that complete cessation state, because of the cause cease completely without remainder, including prisandhi, kamaja rupa, all five aggregates will cease completely without remainder, after pranibbana. Pranibbana is final cessation. So, if you see these two types of cessation, complete cessation, then you should discern. Because of the complete cessation of avijja, prisandhi kamaja rupa cease completely without remainder. Because of the complete cessation of tanha, Parisani Gamaja Rupa is completely without Maida. Because of the complete cessation of clinging, Parisani Gamaja Rupa is completely without Maida. Because of the complete cessation of formations, volitional and formations, Parisani Gamaja Rupa is completely without Maida. Because of the complete cessation of karma, then Parisani Gamaja Rupa is completely without Maida. This is causal cessation state. Then again, you must find this Parisani Gamaja Rupa's dissolution state. This is momentary passing away. So these both causal passing away and momentary passing away also you must listen in the same way. In every mind moment, I aggregate. In every aggregate, you must do in the same way. At that time only, you will understand this way of practice. Oh, if I practice in this way, then one day, all five aggregates will cease completely without Maida. At that time, you want to practice, to continue your practice. Where I will be, these five aggregates will be ceased. You cannot see. Okay? You have no idea.